Ramayana, Part 48. Indrajithu killed. Sri Rama's army charged into Lanka with renewed zest. The guards were in panic at the sight, deserted the fort and fled. The Vanaras lit torches and began to set fire to all Lanka. Mansions and houses and even a portion of the palace were in flames. Pearls, diamonds, opals and gems were burnt to ashes. Thousands of Rakshasas were charred to death. The fire stretched its red flaming tongue in all directions. Women and children bellowed in panic. "It is Pralaya! The day of destruction is here!" they shouted. Flabbergasted, they ran this way and that. In their torment, the Rakshasas could not distinguish between their own forces and others and struck down their own warriors. Horses neighed in pain and elephants trumpeted in agony, and their animals ran helter-skelter, trampling everyone in the way underfoot, and the situation became confusion worse confounded. No matter how hard they tried, the Rakshasas could not take control. The Vanaras had the upper hand. Ravana then sent mighty warriors like Kampana, Prajanga and Kumbha, but they all perished at the hands of the Vanaras. Then came Nikumbha, whom Hanumanta killed, and Makara, whom Sri Rama sent to death. Indrajithu returned to the battle. Once again, he started a battle of illusions. Then Lakshmana bowed to Sri Rama and said, "Brother, I have made up my mind that I shall myself kill Indrajithu. Bless me." Sri Rama embraced and blessed him. Lakshmana, sitting on the shoulder of Hanumanta, went to the battlefield. Indrajithu rained arrows. He also sent forth several deadly weapons without a moment's pause. They pierced Lakshmana's body and blood streamed from the wounds. Stung to the quick, Lakshmana also directed very sharp arrows at Indrajithu. Both were formidable warriors. Each cut in the very air the arrows of the other. Arrows seemed to leap without intermission from the bows of both. Lakshmana shot deadly arrows poisonous like serpents. Indrajithu broke them with 1,000 arrows. Lakshmana rendered ineffective the stinging arrows shot by Indrajithu. As they fought grimly, their armors were broken to pieces. Blood leapt from their bodies like water in a fountain. Their arrows covered the sky itself. Their roars threatened to split open the very skies. They never seemed to tire. So swift were their offenses and responses that it was impossible to see how they took out the arrows and fixed them and shot them, and when the bow changed from one hand to the other. With 4 arrows, Lakshmana killed Indrajithu's charioteer. But Indrajithu was unaffected. He continued the fight even as he took charge of the chariot. With new arrows, Lakshmana broke his chariot. Indrajithu's body was riddled with arrows. He got into another chariot and continued the fight. Lakshmana cut his bowstring. Indrajithu retorted with stinging arrows. They were powerful like Indra's Vajrayudha. They tormented Lakshmana. He cut a weapon known as Rathashakti, shot by Indrajithu. When Indrajithu employed a terrifying weapon endowed with the power of sacred verses, Lakshmana retaliated with an awesome arrow. The two unearthly and blazing weapons collided in mid-air fully. A huge fire rose to the skies. Both were enraged that their arrows had been rendered ineffectual. Lakshmana shot the Varunastra and Indrajithu replied with the Raudrastra. Lakshmana overcame Indrajithu's Agneyastra with his Saurastra. Indrajithu shot the Asurastra, and at once several weapons like swords, axes and maces leapt from it and sped towards Lakshmana, but he overcame it with the Maheshwarastra. Finally, Lakshmana fixed the blazing Aindrastra to the bowstring, empowered it with the appropriate sacred words and directed it against Indrajithu. With dazzling brilliance, it leapt to him, cut off Indrajithu's head and threw it away. The very gods applauded the victory. The Vanaras shouted in triumph. The Rakshasas fled in panic. The battlefield was filled with the Vanaras' roars of victory. The news of Indrajithu's death struck Ravana like a thunderbolt. He fell down like a tree, the roots of which have been axed, and wailed heartrendingly. Again and again he swooned. He rolled over in anguish and wailed. After a while he collected himself. He thought, "Well, I shall surely wreak vengeance." He prepared to go to the battlefield. When Ravana himself set forth, what followed needs no description. The surviving Rakshasas felt a new confidence surging within them. They picked up their weapons and ascended their chariots. Ravana too ascended his chariot. warning omens greeted him on the way, but he ignored them. As soon as Ravana entered the battlefield, Lakshmana began an onslaught, but Ravana cut his arrows into pieces in the air itself. A fierce battle raged between Ravana and Lakshmana. Lakshmana cut the standard on the chariot of Ravana and killed his charioteer and his horses. Ravana was furious and shot the Shakti Ayudha. Lakshmana fell down unconscious. Sri Rama then sent forth the powerful astras and forced Ravana to leave the battlefield. Hanumanta once again went to the Himalayas and brought the Aushadha mountain. The breeze blowing over the Sanjivani restored Lakshmana.